Hi guys,
hi,
and welcome back to our Black History Month celebration, and welcome back to my channel, Tassie with an H, as we read
Little Legends, Exceptional Men in Black History.
Cool. So, have you learned a lot so far about each little legend?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Alright, so, now if you've missed some of our videos of Little Legends for the beginning parts of February, feel free to go back and listen to those other videos. So we're going to get right into it. Today we're reading about Alvin Ailey.
And he is a...
Choreographer.
Choreographer.
And he was around from 1931 to 1989.
And a choreographer is...
Choreographer?
Choreographer is a person who teach dance moves, but I was thinking a person who teach Japanese dance moves.
Well, I mean, I guess he could incorporate some Japanese or other culture dances and moves.
Okay.
I guess. Alright, so let's get right into it. Alvin was a quiet kid. While growing up in rural Texas, he and his mother moved from place to place. They always found community, though, in the local black churches and dance halls. In 1943, they moved to Los Angeles, where Alvin was introduced to dance and theater. While Alvin was in junior high school, he went on a class trip to see the Ballet Russe de Monte Carlo. But it was a performance by Catherine Denham's company, one of the first black modern dance troupes in America, that sparked his interest in the art form. However, he didn't consider studying dance until he was inspired by a classmate's performance at school. Alvin couldn't believe a boy was dancing.
Boy can always dance.
In 1949, Alvin attended the Lester Horton Dance Theater, America's first integrated dance company. The dancers learned techniques from Native America, Japanese, Caribbean, Japanese, and Balinese traditions.
See, so that means he teaches that to Japanese moves.
Yeah.
See, so ask correct.
Yeah, you were. Alvin trained with Horton on and off for a few years. When Horton died suddenly, Alvin took over as a director and lead choreographer, even though he was only 22 years old.
22? That's almost like a teenager or a grown-up or something.
A very young grown-up, yeah. In 1954, Alvin moved to New York City. The civil rights movement had begun, and Alvin wanted to contribute by sharing his art. He formed the Alvin Ailey American Dance Theater in 1958 and used dance to affirm that black people were a part of American culture. His work during this period recalled his childhood in Texas. Blues Suite, his first solo success, drew from a dance hall he had frequented. Revelations was based on his experience in the Baptist Church and is still performed to this day. He focused on black dancers and choreographers, but included dancers of every race. Nicknamed American Cultural Ambassador to the World, the troupe traveled all over. In 1969, he opened the Alvin Ailey American Dance Center to foster creativity in underserved communities. Alvin helped popularize modern dance internationally and brought more African Americans into the field. He shared his vision of blackness while inspiring dancers everywhere. Very cool indeed. So, Alvin Ailey, I think I've been to maybe one Alvin Ailey dance performance. And it was amazing. The dancers, the way they moved, the choreography, everything was exceptional.
I wasn't there.
No, you were not born yet.
Oh.
So, have you guys heard of Alvin Ailey before today?
Yeah.
She hasn't. So, if you haven't, now is your chance to Google and find out more.
If he teaches other country dance moves.
Yeah, yes. Apart from Japanese, Caribbean, and the others.
Yeah, like Canada dance moves. Like, Canada doesn't have dance moves.
Maybe folk dancing. Probably. So, once again, thank you guys for joining us for our reading of Little Legends. And, as usual, make sure you...
give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and turn on your notifications so you don't miss when we post up another video.
And we'll see you guys in the next video.
Bye!